Welcome back to Taronga TV. I'm with Susie. Susie looks after all the education animals here at the Institute of Science and Learning here at Taronga. Susie, welcome.
Thank you, Hayden.
Thank you very much for showing us this exquisite creature. Folks, you're not going to believe what this is. This creature in adult size can grow up to how long?
Up to about 6 metres.
6 metres, about 20 feet for you old school people there, like me, 20 feet. Any guesses at home? Yep, you got it. This is a saltwater crocodile. I can't believe it's so beautiful, Suze. Talk us through.
Yeah, he's pretty cute. This is Sarko. So he's a juvenile saltwater crocodile. Believe it or not, he's over a year old.
Wow.
Even so small, but they take a long time to grow to adulthood. So they're pretty much growing most of their lives until they're really, really big.
So there's a lot of interesting things I think you'll find fascinating here from Susie about saltwater crocs and crocodiles in general. They're quite maternal for a reptile, aren't they? Or quite, they're a dinosaur in a way. Could you talk us through, after they've mated, what happens next?
Yeah, they are very maternal. So the mum actually will stay with her babies for a very, very long time. So she does a lot of nest building, and that's where, so she'll collect vegetation, she'll break it off with her teeth, with her mouth. She'll use her back legs to scrape it up onto a big bank and make it a really big mound so that she can sort of control the temperature with inside that mound. She'll lay about 60 eggs inside there, and she'll sit on the mound protecting it for about 3 months that she's protecting that mound until they hatch. So she'll know that they've hatched because she'll hear this very cute little sound. And I've heard that you do the sound very, very well.
I've actually heard that you do the sound very, very well, Sue. So I think we're going to have a crocodile baby vocalisation off. I made that up.
All right, I'll go.
Go on.
That's pretty good.
You vote on who the winner is there, folks. I think it's going to be her somehow. But anyway, Susie did a great... That's that little vocalisation that they make in the nest as they're emerging, correct?
Yeah, so mum will hear that and she'll actually assist them by breaking open the mound. If some of them are having trouble hatching, she'll actually roll them around a little bit to help break the shell. And what she'll do is she'll scoop up as many as she can in her mouth, very, very gently with all those teeth, and she'll carry them down to the water.
Now, there's another really interesting thing about that nest, isn't there? Temperature plays an incredibly important role on whether they're male or female. How does that work?
Yeah, it's very, very cool. So the temperature that the eggs are incubated at will determine the sex or the gender of that crocodile. So sort of less than 30 degrees or above 33 degrees, generally about 85% of them will be female. And in between that 30 to 32 degree mark, they'll generally be male. So it's very, very interesting.
3 degree window.
3 degree window will determine what gender they are.
That is incredible. And we still don't really know the reason behind that.
Yeah, it's a bit of a scientific mystery. It's very, very interesting.
I love scientific mysteries. If you want to look more of that up, look online and see if you can find out why that temperature is so important to the sexes of crocodiles when they're born. Now, in the wild, what would they eat as little juveniles this age?
Yeah, so at this age, they'll pretty much eat anything they can get their hands on or their teeth on. So you're looking at small fish, crustaceans. Sarko here, his favourite thing, small yabbies. He absolutely loves. Any little mammal that might come down to the water and things like that as well.
He is really beautiful, isn't he?
He is gorgeous.
The modifications too. There's his eyes on the top of the head, nostrils on the top of the head. That's for fantastic immersion in the water.
Yeah.
And they're top line predators, aren't they?
They are. They're an apex predator. So when they're an adult, there's not much that can challenge them. Having said that, you can see how small Sarko is. So when they're born, they're only around 70 grams, around 28 centimetres long. And you know, they are small and they need a lot of help protection. So mum will actually stay with them for about 8 months. She'll protect them in what's called a crèche or a pod, and she'll keep them all together and try and keep as many as she can safe. The mortality in when they're this little is quite high because they are small. So it's important for mum to stick around until they're about Sarko size or even a little bit smaller and they're on their own from about 8 months.
You'd have to be pretty courageous to take on a mother saltwater crocodile for her young, wouldn't you? What would be a predator for these little guys?
Well, when they're this small, it's things like birds of prey, so eagles on the land, even like a feral cat and that sort of thing would go for them. Snakes, pythons that come down to the water edge as well.
And here at Taronga in our care, what would Sarko eat in a week?
Yeah, so he gets quite a varied diet. As I said, he gets small yabbies, different types of fish, so little white bait, things like that, crickets and locusts. He loves chasing those around, even small mice as well.
Okay. Mm. He is absolutely beautiful. So if you've been to Taronga before, you may have seen our large, our huge, about 4 meters long Rin Tin Tin, our big crocodile down near the concert lawns of the zoo. Please come back and have a look at him. But if you've got a school that's coming to the Taronga Institute of Science and Learning, you might get the opportunity to meet Sarko, and he is absolutely sensational. Susie, thank you for your time. Really appreciate
it. You're welcome.
It's just another fantastic thing that you can see on Taronga TV, and you never know what's around the next corner. We'll see you next time.